bringing news that matters to you. You're watching The Bahamas Tonight, Northern Edition.
Welcome back. Our neighbors to the north, the United States of America, gearing up for a highly contested general election this November. Those eligible to vote are being advised that they can do so even if they are overseas. Officer responsible for safety and welfare of the U.S. Embassy's American Citizen Services, Brandon Borkowitz, explains.
If you're registering to vote, is a website called fvap.gov.gov. So that's fvap.gov. It stands for the Federal Voting Assistance Program. It is for people who live overseas, U.S. citizens who live overseas who want to register to vote. It provides information if the U.S. citizen actually has a residency in the United States. It provides information about each state's absentee ballot program. So more than likely at this point, most states have gone through their primary season, so that it may be a little too late for that, but we still have plenty of time to register for the general election.
Borkowitz contends that it is important for all U.S. residents throughout the Bahamas to cast their vote.
Have overseas ballots. Again, generally for people who have some sort of residency, so dual residence is the target audience. The website may be a little bit on the military jargon side because it is primarily directed towards our biggest expat community, which is U.S. Military members who live overseas. But it provides assistance for all U.S. citizens who are overseas.
Elections in the United States will be held on November 1st. The power of social media to be explored tomorrow during a one-day summit, the Parley, to take place at the Grand Lucayan Resort is expected to attract local and international delegates. Organizers of the event say the benefits of social media cannot be denied, and it is time to look at ways it can be used to boost business.
Features a wide range of international speakers who are coming in to talk on various topics to do with social media. And the theme of this is maximizing profits through social media, which is very important because so many people look at the social media, the Facebook and Instagram and all of that, and they see it really as time wasting. But actually there is a business application to it, and the social media app actually represents a whole shift in the way of doing business.
This is a great stimulant for our economy, just getting all of the businesses involved, because we say it all the time that tourism is everybody's business, but there's a new way that we share and we make this business go viral, and that's the internet. So social media is exciting. We're glad to be a part of this.
And now it's time to ask the doctor.
Hi and welcome. Each year, the World Health Organization chooses a health topic to focus health education and activities around World Health Day, which is celebrated on April 7th. This year, the focus is on beating diabetes. So this week, I will discuss this important topic and how we can halt and prevent this disease worldwide. Diabetes is a chronic disease that occurs either when the pancreas does not produce enough insulin or when the body cannot effectively use the insulin it produces. Insulin is a hormone that regulates blood sugar. Hyperglycemia, or raised blood sugar, is a common effect of uncontrolled diabetes and over time leads to serious damage to many of the body's systems. The number of persons living with diabetes is increasing rapidly worldwide, and more than 80% of diabetes deaths occur in low and middle income countries. The World Health Organization projects that diabetes will be the seventh leading cause of death in 2030. So a healthy diet, regular physical activity, maintaining a normal body weight, and avoiding tobacco use can prevent or delay its onset. I'm Dr. Monique Pratt, and this has been Ask the Doctor.
Sports is up next with Ricardo Lightbourne.